from India. One's a film scholar and a filmmaker, Ashok Vishwanathan, a columnist, and also Imtiaz Ali, in conversation with Imtiaz Ali, who's an acclaimed, internationally acclaimed filmmaker and a commentator. So we are going to find out Ray in resurgence in the country. Well, when Satyajit Ray began with his film, Pothir Panchali, the entire concept of independent cinema was very different. And today, the meaning, the earth of independent cinema is different. So let's understand how relevant is Ray for us with Ashok Vishwanathan in conversation with Imtiaz Ali. Ladies and gentlemen, more sessions coming on Earth, a culture fest, specially partnered by Shalimar Chef Spices, tea partner Goodreek Tea, and promoted by Z. Thank you very much.
Hello, Imtiaz. Hello.
Hi.
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 Ashok here.
Hi, Ashok.
Just before, thank you. I don't know whether you recall, you came to SRFTI some time back and we had a
of
session
course.
There with this. Yes.
Yes, of course. It was a lot of fun. It was, I feel that being in Bengal and talking about arts is a privilege. And especially at your esteemed institute was doubly so
Thank
because
you.
The art in question was cinema.
Thank you. The students loved it. So before we begin, I'll just, although everybody knows it, I'll give a brief overview of Ray because, you know, the newer generation might not know some of the things. So very briefly, Ray came from a family of publishers, painters, artists, writers. His grandfather was Upendra Kishore Rai Choudhury, and he had his business in what is now Bangladesh, East Bengal in those days. His father, Shukumar Ray, was a writer of nonsense verse. So we find that in many of Ray's films, this sense of wit and humor and a certain degree of madness, which is there in Gupi Gain Bhagabain. So maybe his father, Shukumar Ray, who wrote this iconic collection of paintings and poetry called Abul Tabul, which could be translated as nonsense verse, could have influenced him. And of course, as the anchor person rightly said, the concept of independent cinema, as it were, really started with Pothir Panchali, the song of the little road. Now, I'd like Imtiaz to respond to something I'm going to say. One of the most important things in Ray's oeuvre is his storytelling, Essentially, whether he be called a parallel filmmaker or a commercial filmmaker, he was actually a very good storyteller. And in Imtiaz's work also, Imtiaz uses lots of narrative devices of different kinds to tell his stories in a new way. It is there in Jab We Met, where the story finally culminates after moving in several directions. In Highway, it has a very unexpected Stockholm Syndrome kind of a situation. So in all of these, Imtiaz is experimenting with narrative form. So would you say that Ray also, like you, was telling stories in different ways?
It's very embarrassing and humiliating to be that my name is being taken in the same sentence as his. And I don't know what I do, but of course, the fact that Ray basically, I feel in all his films that he had something to say, especially that there was a story and there was something that he wanted to express. And he chose the kind of the language of the film accordingly. So I feel that primarily he was a storyteller. And as we know that films was not the only thing that Ray did. He wrote novels, stories, and he created characters, and he created pieces of art and music and what have you, everything. He published things. And all of it tells a story. So yes, I do believe he was primarily a storyteller.
One of the most interesting stories of course, it's originally based on a Tagore text, was this film called Charulata, which he made in 1964. I think most of us have seen this film. And what is great about this film, apart from the fact that it's a wonderful story being told, he's also delving into then unexplored territory, you know, infidelity or, well, extramarital relationship or woman's desire, you know, exploring these areas. And he does that in such a beautifully subtle way that he actually wins two back-to-back prizes at Berlin. No other filmmaker in the history of cinema has won back-to-back Best Director prizes in Berlin. He won it for Mahanagar the previous year, and the next year he wins it for Charulata. So, Imtiaz, have you seen this film, Charulata?
Incidentally, it happens to be the first film of Ray that I saw.
Wow.
And before which I had heard of Ray while growing up, and I'm sure that I'd seen snatches of films, especially Gopi Gayan and various others. My parents and everybody around me was a huge fan. They were talking. But since Bengali is not my natural language, and since I've not been raised in Bengal, I didn't really get to see the film as such, any of his films. But Charulata happened then to be the first film that I saw when I was old enough to appreciate it, I feel. And also, I was also young enough to feel how different it was from anything I had seen or any story that I had been told. And I was stunned by it, actually. I was stunned. I felt that how could he say these things which I've seen around me or sensed them around me, and he said it so beautifully, so poetically, without casting judgment on anybody. None of the characters appear to be in the wrong in that movie, and beautifully told. So yes, I started watching other films gradually.
And you know, in your cinema, you direct, you produce, and you also are not really judgmental, you know, in your cinema. If you look at Highway, which is, I think, the high point in your oeuvre, would you say that you've made the film without judging anyone, you know, the criminal, so-called criminal, whatever?
Well, that was a big struggle, and I've thought after making Highway a lot about that character. Because given the cyclical nature of abuse, it is only about whose story is being told. Sometimes there have been times when I was thinking about the character that committed the abuse and wondering what would have happened to him to make him like this. To go to that extent was not possible for this narrative. But yes, I do feel that I was judgmental to him. You know, I was judgmental to him and that setup of that society. You know, the father, the mother, etc., who could not protect their baby child and who had the compulsion of actually neglecting her, this abuse. Much like many people in our society. So there was no time to actually talk about their part of the side of the story.
And we found in many of Ray's films, he has these characters who have shades of grey, and he doesn't either dislike them or like them, but he presents them in quite a few films.
Right. Yes.
And you're working in the mainstream, but within that, you're always trying to do new things. Is that a risk at any time? Because you're also into the financial part of it. So is that a risk?
Well, when I made Highway, when I told Rahman sir the story, I remember he was the first person, A.R. Rahman, to tell me that I'm happy you're making this film. So you are not a prize horse. You're not running, you're not a horse in the horse race. You can do, because at that point of time, Highway was a very small budget film. And it wouldn't really, it was not expected to get the financial return that my other films were getting or what I was. So it's like a wasted opportunity economically for everybody. So the commercial market would always look like somebody like me like that, that if there is a film of so-and-so director, then it is possible to generate this kind of money. And of course, the director himself gets a bit of it. So, but the fact that I was going against that and making a film which was a small budget, non-actors, non-stars, it was something I wanted to do. He felt nice because he felt that, oh, so ultimately this guy wants to tell his stories, whichever way it happens. So, I have not really wasted time in understanding the difference between different types of cinema. Luckily, I've been untutored and I came into cinema at a time when almost everything that you could say to uphold a tradition, there was also logic to oppose it, you know. So, like if you would say that a formula film works, then I could say that, but so many have failed. And if you could say that, like, you know, when I made my first film, someone told me that it cannot be made because a love story has to have a villain. So in your film, there is no barrier between the boy and the girl. So it won't work. But every time when you give them logic and they feel the story is good and they can make money out of it, they agree, you know, they come along with you. So I went on with that. But yes, sometimes there are expectations, financial expectations that you've got to work with.
Now, you said something which is very important, that you came untutored. You know, here again, yes. We can talk of Ray, because actually Ray, when he made his first film, he had not gone to any film institute. He had not assisted any eminent filmmaker. In fact, he had not assisted anyone at all. His cameraman, the DOP, director of photography, was a still photographer. In fact, they didn't actually know role, action, and these directions they didn't know. There was only one person on the set called Bansi Chandragupt, who was a very important art director, originally from Kashmir, who knew these directions and who helped them. So here again, although you might feel embarrassed, here is another point of comparison with Ray. He came completely untutored, and that was perhaps working in his favor. Would you say that in your case also, the fact that you didn't come with any baggage, that helped you?
Oh, I think it helped me in the long run, but in the short run, it gave me a lot of anxiety. Because when I landed up at a set for the first time, I realized I was the director. And at that time, unlike Ray's situation, the unit had already done shooting before. I was perhaps the youngest member of this unit and the only one who was not experienced in shooting, and somehow freak accident that I was the director. But yes, over the years, I realized that everything that I learned was on the job, and it was I learned it because I wanted to do my job, you know. So I had to learn it to carry on. Like if I'm already on the set and there is a camera, then I have to look through it and figure out how it looks at different lenses. And so somebody says, should I put a 75 or a 50? Then, you know, I'll have to see what the hell a 75 or a 50 is. At the same time, not scaring them by saying, I don't know what the difference is. Pretending that I know and seeing it and learning at that point. So obviously it gives you a lifelong impetus to learn new things to begin with. The second thing is also the fact that I had the compulsion of only telling the stories that came to me in the way that it came to me, you know. And then I feel that if somebody, I'm all for tutoring, I'm all for film institutes and working as assistants, etc. But the unlearning is also important to be able to tell your vision, whatever it is, and not having an accent of any other director. So yes, I was lucky that I had to only learn and not unlearn.
And here there's an advantage of being untutored, which Ray also had, and you are making diverse films. You know, Rockstar has a completely different kind of an ambiance, a different milieu, different setting, different characters to, let's say, Jab We Met. So you are open to different kinds of exploration, which I think Ray was doing in his 26, 27 films that he made. He has something like Pratidwandi, which is a very avant-garde, modern-day kind of film. And he also ends up by making Agantuk, which is again in the classical mold. So he's moving in several directions like you.
No, I would like to move in some of these different directions for sure. And I mean, thank you very much for even mentioning that, because I'll also further keep in mind that, like I believe about Ray, that the film or the story dictates the treatment. You know, that is what makes him so different. For in each film, it's almost it is Ray, but you know, it seems like a different Ray.
And only one thing about you said about not knowing much about cinema, but because of your background in Jamshedpur, you were associated with some theater halls, so you must have been seeing a lot of films.
Yes, I was, of course, seeing a lot of films, and every type of film that was available, I wanted to watch. My parents, luckily, had a very a taste in parallel cinema, so-called, at that point of time. You know, they would see Ray and they would see Shyam Benegal. And so I used to get snatches of these films as I grew up. So I was aware of that sensibility. Like if Junoon would come and play in a theater in Rupak Cinema, Patna, I would be taken to watch it. As a kid who perhaps didn't understand it, but I was aware of that kind of cinema. And at the same time, my relatives had cinema theaters. So as a kid, I could get in almost like a Cinema Paradiso situation. I actually knew the projectionist. I've actually helped him load the reel and look through that that hole and see what is happening and how the sounds are in the cinema theater. And so I had the exposure of all kinds of films, and I liked all kinds of cinema. So yes, I did see a lot of films.
Very interesting. You're able to actually do the projection, because in celluloid, the projection is much more difficult. You know, threading the projector, and it can go wrong, and you know, can get cut also. So in the fact that you knew it, it's a great thing. You know, when I was in the Film Institute in Pune, we were working in celluloid, so we were taught these things. It was quite difficult. Ray, in one film which is very little known, not many people have seen, it's called Chidiya Khana, The Menagerie. It's written by this famous writer called Saradindu Bandopadhyay, who used to write the Bomkesh stories. So this is a Bomkesh Bakshi story, in which he has an old cinema hall in which they go, the detectives, to see a film in which an old-time heroine has acted. And she is linked to the murder which has happened. So he shows that, you know, the projection, they're sitting in the hall. And sometimes when we see these films, and when I hear you saying that you know about projection, you do feel a little sad that, you know, the reels are no longer there.
That's true. That's true. Because there is that, the visual of the reel and the smell of, newly processed reel. And also there is some splendor to that way of working, I feel. I feel that the biggest advantage of me and you having spent time making films on film is the fact that you had to know your mind before the shot.
Exactly. That's very important. You know, we forget this is...
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, go on, want one line. That is that now, you know, people are taking shots from different angles. They're making it a coverage kind of thing. You know, that confuses the director. unless the director has a specific vision, which in celluloid he couldn't do that because it is very expensive. That's all I want to say.
Exactly. So, in fact, the first movie that I made on the digital format was Highway. That is because I knew I'm on the journey and I don't know when I'll have to roll and how much I'll have to roll. And even then, and even now, whenever I'm working on the digital format also, I am going to take a take only when I know that this can be okay. I am against this concept of, like, because I've started in film, or the basic training is in film, I'm against the concept of, let's roll the rehearsal, so to speak. That is so odd. Because then there is no vision. Then that can have no
vision. And, you're leaving it to the editor and the editing table, but the director is absent there. You know, he's taken all possible angles without knowing which one he actually wants to do. And some of them, I'm sorry to bring in a technical point, I also act in a few films. I'm seeing him taking a close-up, and then he's taking the same shot with the crane. I say that if the crane is going to be moving, you're not going to cut into the crane shot with a close-up. Why are you taking both the shots? I don't understand. This is something. Yeah. Ray writes, he also used to write very well. Yes. He says that he used to do the editing in the camera itself, meaning he would know just how much is required, how much is necessary. Yeah. And of course, as you say, that time celluloid, and we knew the value of celluloid. Somehow now with a lot of things, we are not realizing the value of it. And that's how we're shooting. This is a problem.
One thing is the value. The other thing also which I feel is that what is the vision there? I feel that cinema is a process of translating a picture in your mind onto the film, you know, onto the celluloid or onto the screen, whichever way you do it. What are you seeing in your mind that you're translating? It can't be from every angle. You know, it has to be from a certain magnification. You see a girl sitting at the bus stand, there's a certain look to it, you know. It can't be that, you know, get an actor, give her the dialogue, make her sit, and then just shoot. Because then, why do we need the director? Actually, the cameraman can shoot if the actor goes and sits over there, and the editor can edit. The sound guy will, you know, record the sound, so you don't really need the director.
Yes. We're coming to the end of the interaction. Just wanted to ask you, what do you think are some of the major qualities that you would appreciate in a filmmaker like Satyajit Ray?
Well, Satyajit Ray had vision. There was something very specific and beautiful about every frame, every word, every note of music. The choice of actor, the choice of singer. Like, he had Kishore Kumar come in and sing one song in Charulata. I don't know whether they collaborated ever before or after. Because he needed that voice for that character. And I feel that he had vision. He had something to say. And something to say is not necessarily words.
Correct.
So if I see anything of Satyajit Ray, it is not coming from a space of not knowing what it would be. It is something that he's saying. Like, there is a thing in his brain.
Exactly.
And he's taking pains to create it. Yeah.
In this context, one shot in a film called Seema Badh Company Limited. It's about the corporate sector in Calcutta. There is a time when one of the executive directors, or just below the executive director, he is in a conspiratorial mode. Wo ek conspiracy hatch kar raha hai with a worker. To phone uthata hai aur pehle phone dikhaya jata hai aur wo kuch whisper karta hai phone pe. Uske baad wo tilt down karke wo coil ke upar chala jata hai. Sare conversation, the dialogue is not in lip sync, it's on that coil. So that means he knows exactly this is a secret conversation. Or wo conspiracy bhi hai, or wo coil bhi hai. So this is exactly what you're saying. He has the vision to know what shot to take.
Yes, and how to light it, what the face is. So to have that picture in your mind is important for for a film director. That's specifically what we should follow and learn from Ray.
Another area where you are very proficient, I find, in most, is your choice of music and the background score and also the soundtrack, you know. You used to work in Fiesta, if I remember, and I share the same sound recordist, friend of mine.
Alok De.
Yes, Alok De. So, for example, some of your films, the music you use, Rashid Khan also. Can you just say, I mean, what are your inspirations or your feel for music, if you could say something?
Well, a couple of things. I feel that I was blessed to be born in a home where music was of a, like a high quality, so to speak. And also a classical base, and also good poetry in any language. But the standard, just the level of it was quite interesting. They were very, like the masters would be singing in a tape recorder around the time that, you know, in my early homes. So that got imbued. Like, I used to not really enjoy the classical masters at that time at all. And I was wondering why they don't put Kishore Kumar songs only, and you know, that kind of thing. But over the years, when I went back to music, or when I realized, then now I look back at those people differently. But so basically, I had a journey in music, and at that time, my mom thought that I could sing very well, and so as a kid, she put me into to learning classical singing. But I was a small kid. I went for a few months and then I ran away, because it was the same time as I would get to play cricket. So I went to that. But I feel that there was something that I had tasted, and then in my life I couldn't go back to actually playing or singing music. So maybe that also attachment I have is like an unfulfilled dream with which I go to a studio and work with musicians. At least it is the most thrilling time in making the film for me, to be in the company of them, and you know, they are playing and you are talking to them. That's like being inside a concert.
Thank you very much. It's been very rewarding interaction. Thank you very much, Imtiaz, for being with us. I'll just end by just summing it up in Bangla, because the program will also go in Bangla. তো আমাদের সঙ্গে ছিলেন ইমতিয়াজ আলী, প্রসিদ্ধ চলচ্চিত্র পরিচালক, যার একাধিক ছবি জনপ্রিয় হয়েছে এবং ভীষণ শিল্পসম্মতও বটে, বিশেষ করে হাইওয়ে, জব উই মেট, রকস্টার প্রভৃতি। তিনি সত্যজিৎ বাবু নিয়ে বললেন এবং ওনার দুটি কথা আমার মনে হয় অত্যন্ত গুরুত্বপূর্ণ। প্রথমত, আজকের এই ডিজিটাল যুগে আমরা কভারেজ করছি, মানে যে কোনো পরিস্থিতিকে বিভিন্ন দৃষ্টিকোণ থেকে আমরা শট নিচ্ছি, এটা না নিয়ে যদি একটা দূরদর্শিতা থাকে পরিচালকের মধ্যে, তাহলে তার মনের মধ্যে সে ঠিক করে নেবে যে কোন শটটা নিতে হবে, তাহলে বোঝা যাবে যে তার পরিচালক সত্তা জাগ্রত আছে। আর উনি যেটা বললেন যে তার প্রথম দেখা সত্যজিৎ বাবুর ছবি চারুলতা, এবং চারুলতা দেখে খুবই প্রভাবিত হয়েছিলেন, অসাধারণ লেগেছিল। তাঁর অনেক ছবিতে আমরা দেখেছি বিভিন্ন ধরনের বিষয় নিয়ে উনি কাজ করেছেন, যেমন সত্যজিৎ বাবু কাজ করতেন। পরিশেষে যে কথাটা বলতে চাই, সত্যজিৎ বাবুর ক্ষেত্রে তিনি এসেছিলেন সম্পূর্ণ তাঁর মতে অশিক্ষিত, যদিও নিজের শিক্ষা করেছিলেন। ইমতিয়াজ আলীও বলছেন যে তিনি এসেছিলেন আনটিউটার্ডভাবে, শিক্ষা না নিয়েই, এবং সেটা একটা সুবিধে হয়েছে, যদিও প্রথম দিকে কিছু অসুবিধে হয়েছিল, কারণ ইউনিটের লোকজন শ্যুট করেছিলেন। সত্যজিৎ বাবুর ক্ষেত্রে ডিওপিও আগে শ্যুট করেনি। তো আমাদের অত্যন্ত মূল্যবান একটা অন্তরঙ্গ আলাপ আলোচনা হলো। আই থ্যাংক ইমতিয়াজ ওয়ান্স এগেন, অ্যান্ড উই মাস্ট মিট এগেন, বিকজ
ইয়েস আই উইল বি লুকিং ফরওয়ার্ড।
ইয়েস, থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ, নমস্কার, নমস্কার।
Go, 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 go,